This is the SAP Developer News for April 17th,
The SQL on files capability in SAP HANA Cloud has unlocked new potential by providing direct read-only SQL access to files stored in SAP HANA Cloud and data lake files since QRC 03-2024. Starting with the QRC 04-2024 of SAP HANA Cloud, this capability has been further extended to support direct access to the most common external object storages in addition to SAP HANA Cloud-owned data lake files, namely Amazon S3, Azure Blob Storage or ADLS Gen 2, and Google Cloud Storage. With the ability to access vast volumes of data from managed object stores, you can fully leverage the robust features of SAP HANA Cloud as a platform. This includes in-memory processing, machine learning capabilities, predictive analytics library, and so forth. Another piece of good news is that the existing limitations on Delta tables, which previously supported only reader version 1 for both direct file access and Delta sharing, has been lifted starting with the SAP HANA Cloud QRC 01 this year. For hands-on exercises, check the updated tutorials at Explore SAP HANA Cloud, SAP HANA Database SQL on Files.
The SAP Process Orchestration to SAP Integration Suite migration tool now supports the automatic creation of integration archetypes, supporting the pipeline for cloud integration. This update simplifies the shift from SAP Process Orchestration by using a pattern-based method that automatically generates integration artifacts and makes your integration flow cleaner, smarter, and way easier to manage. Now, the pipeline model offers better error handling, fewer queues to juggle, and reusable components that save you time. No more stressing over rigid templates. Instead, it identifies supported patterns, making more scenarios eligible for migration. To learn more about this, check the link in the description below.
If you're a user of the SAP Business Technology Platform, whether using applications or services offered by SAP or by others, this is an important item, especially if you manage trust certificates yourself. There's a change to the Root Certificate Authority, CA, used to issue certificates on SAP domains for Cloud Foundry, basically the TLS handshake between your browser and the server. This is for environments on BTP. This change is due to a recommendation from the Bundesamt für Sicherheit in der Informationstechnik, that's the German Federal Office for Information Security. In essence, there's an old G2 certificate, the DigiCert Global Root CA, and that's being replaced by a newer DigiCert TLS RSA 4096 Root G5. You can manage Root Certificate Authority certificates yourself, or, and this is what we recommend because it makes it a lot easier, you can use the BTP Trust Store. In any case, you must make sure that your Trust Store does contain this new G5 certificate, especially if you do manage the trust store yourself. Anyway, for all the details, check out the blog post that's linked in the description.